गुड मॉर्निंग, आई एम प्रोफेसर अजय जोशी एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मटेरियल. ओके, इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन वी विल डिस्कस फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स एंड मैकेनिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स. ओके, वी विल मोस्टली स्टडी द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स हियर. ओके, बिकॉज आवर सब्जेक्ट इंजीनियरिंग मेटलर्जी मोस्टली डील्स विद मेटल्स. सो material properties means material properties can be classified into chemical properties, then physical properties, then mechanical properties, and then dimensional related properties. Okay, in chemical properties we can have composition. Okay, composition of material, then it is oxide or it is compound. Okay, then acidity or alkalinity of material, it is acidic in nature or basic in nature or alkaline in nature. Okay, this comes under chemical properties. Then weathering conditions or weathering corrosions. Okay, so these are the chemical properties of material. Okay, in physical properties, density is the physical property. Okay, density is the mass per unit volume. Then conductivity. Conductivity means thermal conductivity as well as electrical conductivity, means material can conduct thermal heat, can conduct heat or can conduct electrical power or electricity. That comes under the physical properties. Conductivity comes under physical properties of metals or materials. Next is acoustic properties. Okay, acoustic properties. Acoustic means sound related properties. So sound transmission and absorption, that comes under acoustical properties. Next is optical properties. Optical means light related properties, means light will pass or not. Okay, so that comes under optical properties of material. Then combustibility. Combustibility means material can burn or cannot burn. Okay, that comes under combustibility. So examples is fuel is a combustible material. Okay, so all these properties come under physical properties of material. Next one is mechanical properties. In mechanical properties, there are some strength. Okay, strength means tensile strength or compressive strength or shear strength or creep strength, all comes under this strength or mechanical properties. Next is toughness. Okay, toughness or stiffness, then elasticity, then plasticity, then ductility, then brittleness and hardness, all comes under mechanical properties. In our subject, we will mostly study physical properties and mechanical properties of material. Okay, we will study all these definitions in coming slides. Then dimensional related properties, size, shape, these are the dimensional related properties. Then properties of material, first we will see mostly physical properties of materials. First one is density. You all know density is mass per unit volume. Okay, and its unit is kg per meter cube. Kg is the unit of mass, and meter cube is the unit of volume. Okay, meter cube or centimeter cube is the unit of volume. Okay, next is a tensile strength. It is the ability of material to withstand tensile forces or loads without breaking. Okay, for example this is my fixed rod, this is rod which is fixed from this end, and if I apply tensile force from this portion, okay, from this side, this is the tensile force. Okay, after implementation or after application of tensile force, this rod will be elongated, will get elongated. Okay, for example, this is my new rod. Okay, after application of forces, so this is the deflection, this is the deflection. Okay, for example, D is the deflection. By these tensile forces, our rod is not braked. Okay, our rod is not braked. So this is the tensile strength of this material. Okay, for example, this is mild steel rod, okay. So this is the maximum tensile strength of this rod, okay. If I apply some amount of force here and if it is breaked, then that is the maximum tensile strength of this material, okay. So this is the tensile strength. Next is the strength, okay. Strength is the ability of material to resist applied forces without fracturing. So strength is a broad term. In that term we have tensile strength, okay. Strength is a broad term, and in that we have tensile strength, then compressive strength, then shear strength. So strength is the bigger terminology which deals with or which studies the ability of material to resist applied forces in any direction. Means, for example, this is my material, and if I applied this type of forces, that is tensile forces, this is tensile force. If I applied such type of forces, that is compressive, okay, this is compressive force. If I apply pair of forces, for example, this one and this one, after application of, for example, I will write here, yes, okay. So after application of tensile forces, material get elongated and will not break. So that is the tensile strength of material. If I apply compressive forces and material will not break, so that is compressive type of strength, compressive strength of material. And if I applied shear forces and material will not break, so that is shear strength of the material, okay. So that is the strength of material. So in that example you can see this is the material, and after application of this is the compressive force. The man is applying compressive plus some slight shear forces on that rod. So by application of these forces, material is not breaking, material will not break. So that is the compressive strength and shear strength of the material. So this is also an example. I think you already perform this experiment, already performed in 12th class, okay. This is our sample specimen, and I have applied 100 kN load here. After application of this load, this material will not break and it get extended or it will get deflected. So that is the tensile strength of the material, okay, and this is the deflection of material after application of tensile forces, okay. So these are the some properties of material. Now elasticity. So elasticity is another properties, okay, in which we apply some forces on material, and after removal of forces, material will regain its original shape and size, okay. For example, style, okay. So this is our original rod. I applied here load, okay. This is our load, this is the shear tensile types of load from this side also and from this side. Because of that tensile load, our original material get converted into longer rod, okay. You will see here, this is the, for example, this is the L length of rod, original length, and after application of this tensile load, our new length is this. This is L plus delta DL, okay. So additional DL length is created because of this tensile forces, and if I remove this tensile forces after some time, then if it is converted into original shape and size, means if it is converted into this L, okay, means L plus delta L will get converted into this, then we can say this material is elastic material, okay. So it is made from elastic material. It will be of same plane before and after the load applied. It is part of impact that it will be longer whilst the load is being applied. All material possess elasticity to some degree or some extent. Okay, every material you see in nature has some elastic properties. Okay, if I applied more force, okay, then because of that more force or more load, material will not regain its original shape and size, so that comes under plastic material. Okay, so you can see in this example a man is jumping on a, this is disc or plate, man is jumping on this plate, and this is the, you can see this is the compressive forces. Because of that compressive forces, disc get elongated. You can see this is the some elongation is there, but after removal of forces, if man goes up, you can see the plate comes in original shape and size again. So that is the example of plasticity. So plasticity is the property which is exactly opposite to the elasticity. Okay, this plasticity is also important in our engineering. Okay, for casting or elongating the material, plasticity is important. Okay, to create wires or to create a sheets, we have to apply forces, and because of that forces, material get elongated or material get deformed. So that is plasticity material. Okay, so it is the state of material which has been loaded beyond its elastic limit. Okay, we have already seen every material has some elastic limit. Okay, means for example, I will suppose this is a cylindrical rod, and if I applied, for example, I have here 10 kilonewton force. Okay, if I applied 10 kilonewton force here, and because of that force, our rod will get extended or our rod will get elongated, and if I remove that 100 kilonewton load, it will regain its, or it will get its original shape and size. Okay, so if I apply more load, for example, if I apply 100 kilonewton force here, okay, and because of that force, its elastic limit is, for example, 20 kilonewton. Okay, and if I apply 100 kilonewton force, so because of that force, material will get extended or elongated, and if I remove that 100 kilonewton load, then material will not get in there, material will not come in its original shape and size. Okay, so that is the plastic state of the material. Okay, so every material has this, every material has its elastic limit, and after application of more load than its elastic limit, then it will deform permanently, means it will not comes in original shape and size. So these are the some examples of plasticity. For example, this is our plate, and if I applied load, this is the compressive load applied by using punches. Okay, so punches are mostly used in hydraulic press or mechanical press to compress or to shear the material. Okay, here I have applied a small strip here on the lower die. This is the lower die of for example hydraulic press, and this is the upper die of hydraulic press. So die is die. Okay, this is die. So after application of this compressive forces, this strip will get this shape and size. Okay, and after removal of these forces, if I remove these forces, then our material will not get its original shape and size. So that is the example of plasticity. The another example of plasticity is your casting process. We melt our material and pour into the casting, mold casting. Okay, so this is the example of plasticity. देन टफनेस, टफनेस इज ऑल्सो नोन एज इम्पैक्ट रेजिस्टेंस. सो इट इज़ द एबिलिटी ऑफ मटेरियल टू विदस्टैंड बेंडिंग. ओके मीन्स इट विल रेजिस्ट द बेंडिंग. ओके और इट इज़ द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ शेयर स्ट्रेसेस विदाउट फ्रैक्चर. ओके सो द रबर एंड मोस्ट प्लास्टिक मटेरियल डू नॉट शैटर, देयरफॉर दे आर टफ. सो यूनिट ऑफ टफनेस इज जूल पर मीटर क्यूब. यू कैन सी इन दिस एग्जाम्पल दिस इज अवर मेटेलिक प्लेट एंड आई हैव अप्लाइड अ शेयर फोर्स हियर, दिस इज शेयर फोर्स. ओके दिस इज अवर रेजिस्टेंस एंड दिस इज अवर फोर्स. ओके सो दिस पेयर इज नोन एज शेयर फोर्स पेयर. ओके बिकॉज ऑफ दैट फोर्स मटेरियल will get elongated in this direction. Material will get elongated in this direction. And if I remove this force, okay, then material will get its original shape and size. For example, this is original shape and size. Then we can say the material is tough. Okay. Or if material get elongated and if it is not break, okay, because of that shear forces, then also we can call it as material is tough. Means there are two conditions: if material will not bend and material bent and not break. Okay, means first one is to resist or withstand bending, and second one is it will bend but will not break. So that is the toughness or impact resistance of material. Then hardness. So hardness is the ability of material to withstand scratching, that is abrasion or indentation by another hard body. It is the indication of wear resistance of material. For example, if you have I will take example of your mobile phone. For example, this is mobile phone number 1 and this is mobile phone number 2. Okay, and if I have for example a pin, okay, and I use this pin to scratch on your screen. Okay, for example I scratch on mobile number 1 by using pin with same amount of forces I scratch on mobile number 2. Okay, I scratch on mobile number 2. If the scratching is more on mobile number 1 and it is less on mobile number 2, so we can say that the hardness of screen of mobile 2 is more. Okay, means scratch depth is more in 1, means this material is less resistant to the scratching. Means hardness of this material 1 is less and the second material is resisting more to the scratching, means hardness of this material is more. Okay, so hardness is the resistance to the scratching or withstand the scratching. Okay, and second term is indentation. So indentation means how much depth is creating. Okay, by using for example this is my pin, and if I applied if I applied compressive forces by using this pin, and the depth of penetration means how deep this pin goes. For example, this has created, for example, this type of indentation, this type of depth. Okay, for example, this is our screen number 1, mobile screen number 1, and this part is our screen mobile number 2. Okay, and in this screen you get such type of indentation. Okay, then you can say the resistance of screen A is more, it has created less indentation. And in screen 2 you can see there is a more depth of indentation. Hence in this case we can say hardness of screen A is more than hardness of screen B. Okay, so that is the indentation part. So hardness can be measured by scratching or indentation. Rebound hardness means how much bounce has been taken place after impact. Okay, for example, if I have two metallic plates which is fixed on ground, okay, which is fixed on ground, and if I drop a metallic ball, okay, metallic ball of same dimension, size and volume on material with same height, for example this is same height, and if I drop this ball here and here as well, okay, then after impact with this plate, it will, for example, bounce back here, and it will bounce back here, okay, above the, for example, platform. Then you can say the hardness of this second case is more. Why? Because it has more resistance, it offers more resistance to this ball, and because of that there is high impact, and because of that high impact the more height will achieve by ball, and in this case the less resistance offered by this plate, and because of that it will collide here or fall here, and there is a less jump from this ground level. Okay, so that is the rebound hardness. So there are three methods to measure hardness. First one is scratching. By scratching you can determine the hardness, or by indentation with some pin we will force it or penetrate it into the material, and after the studying the depth of penetration you can say you can measure the hardness of material. Or there is third method, that is rebound, means how by using bounce of material. So this example you can see, this is the our indenter, this is our indenter, and this indenter only created some depth here, okay, means it is not penetrated more, and in this case you can see there is a more penetration in this material. So there is a less penetration means more resistance offered by this material, more resistance means more hard material or hard material, and here less resistance offered by this material, hence this is the less hard material or soft material. Okay, so that is hardness, and hardness is very important in our mechanical engineering. We will discuss all these methods to measure the indentation hardness in unit number 5 in detail. Then malleability. So malleability means first I will load complete PPT and then I will told then I will discuss here. So for example, this is my metallic block, and if I apply a compressive forces here or I hammer here multiple times, so because of that hammering it will get converted into such thin sheets, okay, after application of compressive forces multiple times, okay, after repeated multiple compressive forces our solid blocks will get converted into thin sheet. So this property is known as malleability. So malleability is the capacity of substance to withstand deformation under the compressive forces without rupture. Okay, after application of multiple time compressive forces it will not rupture and it will get compressed and converted into thin sheet. So that is malleability. So this is the important term, without rupture or without breakage. Or the malleable material allows a useful amount of plastic deformation. So this is the plastic deformation, means after removal of forces or after removal of hammer it will not get converted into its original shape and size. So that is plastic material, plastic deformation to occur under the compressive loading before fracture occur. Okay, so malleability is often categorized by the ability of material to be formed in the form of thin sheet by hammering or rolling. We have seen here example of hammering, and rolling means there are rollers to compress the materials. Okay, you can see in this example, this is the roller which is rotating, okay, and by means of motor it is rotating, and if material comes from this side, so for example material comes from this side and it will compress that material because of this compressive forces, it will compress that material and a thin material comes from this side, so that is rolling process. Okay, so first one is the hammering and second one is the rolling. This mechanical property is an aspect of plasticity of material. Okay. Malleability of material is temperature dependent. Okay, if you heat the material, it will get easily compressed and without breakage, without rupture, it will easily get compressed. That is hot machining or hot manufacturing type of processes. Okay, if you heat the material, it will get easily compressed or it easily malleable condition. So such a material is required for manipulation by such processes as forging, rolling and rivet heating. Okay, this is the rivet. In this first example, this is the rivet. Mostly rivets are used to hold multiple sheets. Okay, then ductility. So ductility is the property of solid material which indicates how easily a material gets deformed under tensile stresses. I will take another example. If I have a cylindrical rod here and if I applied a tensile load here, so this will get converted into such type of rod. Means what happened here, bigger rod of bigger diameter and bigger cross section area converted into this is small rod of large length and having less cross section. The volume of material 1 and volume of material 2 is same, volume not changed, but you can see the difference is less cross section area in the second long wire and there is a bigger cross section area or more cross section area in this first rod. Okay, this is first rod and this is second rod. Okay, only there is a difference of wire has long length but it has small cross section area. If I increase the cross section area of wire, then it will get converted into cylindrical rod. Okay, so that is the difference between wire and rod. So it refers to the capacity of substance to undergo the deformation under tension without rupture. Okay, rupture is important or failure of material is important in every physical properties or mechanical properties of material. The examples of ductility are wire drawing and tube drawing. Okay, in tube drawing there is a mandrel. Mandrel is used to make a tube. So what is mandrel, we will discuss further. Okay, ductility is often categorized by the ability of material to get stretched into wire by pulling or drawing. This mechanical property is also an aspect of plasticity of material and the temperature dependent. This is also temperature dependent. Okay, you already know that. This with rise of temperature, the ductility of material increases. Okay. Then brittleness. So brittleness of the material indicates that how easily it get fracture when it's subjected to a force. Okay, there that may be a compressive force or tensile force or shear force or crushing force. So brittleness, the best example of brittle material is glass. Okay, if you drop from certain height, means if you drop it from certain height, it will get scattered into multiple pieces. So that is the brittle material. When a brittle material is subjected to stresses, it observes very less energy and gets fracture without significant strain. Brittleness is converse to ductility of material. Brittleness of material is temperature dependent. Brittleness is also temperature dependent. Some metals which are ductile at normal temperature becomes brittle at low temperature. Okay, if you reduce the temperature, material tends to brittle. Okay, so this is also important point here. Then examples are cast iron and glasses. In our metals, cast iron is brittle material. I think you don't know stress and strength here. Strain here. This is stress and this is strain. So stress is force upon area. If I applied force per unit area, that is known as stress. And strain is the ratio of change in length. For example, change in length L1 to the original length L. Or change in, this is the length, if I replace length by another parameter, change in diameter, so that is also strain. So strain is unitless parameter, means length unit is meter, for example, and divided by meter. So meter cancel out and you will not have any unit for strain. And stress is, stress unit is, force unit is Newton, and area unit is meter square. So unit of stress is Newton per meter square. Okay, then next is fatigue. So fatigue is the weakening of material. Weak means it will fail easily. Weak material fail easily of material caused by repeated loading of material. So fatigue is weakening of material caused by repeated loading of material. So best example is, for example, you have a wire. For example, this is your wire, and if you applied multiple time such type of forces, compressive and tensile, compressive and tensile, means you bent multiple time. Okay, so because of that, material get weak. So this material will fail easily because of that multiple time loading and unloading. So this is the best example of fatigue. When a material is subjected to cyclic loading and loading greater than certain threshold value but much below the strength of material, ultimate strength of material or yield strength of material, microscopic means very small cracks begins to form at grain boundaries. We will see what is grain boundaries in later classes and interfaces. Eventually the crack reaches to the critical size and because of that material fails. So because of in simple terms or simple language, fatigue, when you apply cyclic tensile or compressive forces or repeated cyclic forces, because of that repeated cyclic process, material get easily break or material weak, become weak and will break easily. Okay, this crack propagates suddenly and structure get fracture. The shape of structure affects the fatigue very much. Okay, the shape of structure is also important. Square holes and sharp corner leads to elevated stresses, whereas fatigue cracks initiate. Then creep. So creep is the property of material which indicates the tendency of material to move slowly and deform permanently under the influence of external mechanical stresses. So creep is deformation, permanent deformation, which is slow and which is due to the external mechanical stresses. Okay, so it results due to the long time exposure of large external mechanical stresses with in limit of yielding. Okay, we will study this creep apparatus in our practical class. Okay, we already have a setup of creep machine where we put a sample specimen and we will apply a mechanical force for long duration of time, minimum 6 hours, 10 hours, 12 hours. Okay, and because of these forces, material fractures easily or materials fails easily, and in some cases we also increases the temperature of environment. Okay, to test the material under the creep. Creep is more severe in material that are subjected to heat for long time. Okay, so we have this condition in our practical. Okay, we will add heat as well as we will apply the mechanical stresses for long duration of time, and we will determine the creep strength of material. Next is resilience. So resilience is the ability of material to absorb the energy when it is deformed elastically by applying stresses, and raise the energy when it stresses remove. Okay, the best example of resilience is the springs. Okay, spring. When we apply mechanical forces on a spring, particularly helical spring, then spring compressed, and when we remove the forces, then spring releases the energy and comes in its original shape and size. So by this way, spring is the best example for resilient material. Proof resilience is the defined as the maximum energy that can be absorbed without permanent deformation. Okay, it is the maximum energy that can be absorbed without permanent deformation. The modulus of resilience is defined as the maximum energy that can be absorbed per unit volume without permanent deformation. It can be determined by integrating the stress strength curve from zero to elastic limit, and its unit is joule per meter cube. Okay. Then stiffness. So stiffness is the measure of material's ability not to deflect under the applied load. Okay, for example, this is our cast iron plate, and we have applied, you can see, we have applied here tensile forces. So because of the tensile forces, you already know that cast iron is brittle material and it will not deflect easily. Okay, it is not ductile or plastic material. So the cast iron plate will get fracture, but it will not deflect. So cast iron is more stiff than mild steel. In case of mild steel, you can see after application of this tensile forces, sorry, this compressive forces, these are the compressive forces. Okay, so after application of these compressive forces, material will deform here, will get deformed. Okay, material is deformed here. So you can see here, steels are less stiff than cast iron. Okay, so thank you for kind listening.